It has to be said, the visiting judges give life to a photographic society like ours. Without the contribution of our external judges, the competitions would be somewhat limited, and we would undoubtedly miss the feedback from a neutral advisor. However, I think you will agree, some of the judges' comments might require a little translation. We have all heard judges provide feedback, like this. It is a good record shot.
When what they really mean is, you went to this popular location and took the same picture every other photographer took.
This one is a really interesting image, but it is up against some stiff opposition this evening.
There is nothing wrong with this picture, I just don't like it.
We'll hold this one back. I can't promise anything, but I would like to have another look at it.
Let's face it. It's out.
I really like the way this one is framed, with a fine key line around the border.
I can't think of anything complimentary to say about the picture, so I will just compliment the mount.
This one is beautifully printed. Really, well worth a closer look, if you get the chance at the end.
I cannot think of anything complimentary to say about the picture, so I will compliment your printer.
This is a lovely high-key image, with lots of pale pastel shades.
I know you were trying to save money on printer ink.
There are some days, you just have to get up early and capture the beautiful morning light.
Sadly, this was not one of those mornings.
This image shows a pleasing lack of definition.
Not a single thing in this image is sharp.
This is a shot only a photographer would take.
I cannot find anything positive to say about the contents of this picture.
Unfortunately, there are a few distractions in the background.
There is nothing of interest in the foreground, so I went wandering around the background, looking for something of interest.
One of those shots where you got up early to capture the morning light.
You should have stayed in bed.
It's a good idea, but the lighting wasn't quite in your favor.
You should have stayed in bed.
It's a good idea, one well worth revisiting.
Well, you messed that up, better try again.
There are a few dust spots, spoiling this shot. You need to get your sensor cleaned.
I have a Canon 70D for sale, recently serviced, if you are interested.
Here we see the problem of pointing your camera towards the sky. The problem of converging verticals. The buildings look as if they are leaning backwards.
Did I mention, the Canon 70D comes with a tilt-shift lens?
If it was mine, I would have letterboxed it.
There is absolutely nothing of interest in the top and bottom thirds of this picture.
The subject is nicely placed on the thirds.
Yes, I, too, have read the MCPF judging guidelines.
Sometimes, it is worth going back to a location to see how it looks in different light or in different seasons.
Let's face it, could try, but it's out.
A nice landscape that would benefit from a little foreground interest.
As an avid landscape photographer myself, I always carry with me a rusty old boat to add a little foreground interest.
A little too much, rather bland sky.
On the brightest day last summer, you should have gone to the beach with your family, as planned, rather than shoot this picture.
The horizon is too central.
Yes, it is true, rules are there to be broken, but don't expect more than 11 out of 20 if you do choose to break them.
There are a few blown out highlights.
I know you were trying to save on printer ink.
Far too much green.
I am a Rangers supporter.
Far too much red.
I am a City supporter.
The eye of the tiger is not quite as sharp as we would like.
The photographer should have stood their ground and risked losing a limb.
The horizon is not straight.
Nothing a couple of glasses of malt whiskey could not sort out.
I have to say, I have amazed myself at how many of the judges' comments I am able to recall. It just goes to show how much we can learn from our visiting judges and how useful their critique can be in improving our photography.